Another scorcher for Korea, with most parts of the country under either a heat wave advisory or a heat warning, which is a level above an advisory. But for those of us living in the city, the blazing hot temperatures feel and are in fact higher than that temperature intensified by a unique weather phenomenon. Our Lee Unshin explains how we live on an urban heat island.
It was a day of lighter clothes, and fans were a must-have item. But no matter what people did, the blazing conditions on Thursday seemed to have taken over the streets and dominated all aspects of daily life. Already expected to be the hottest day this year so far, the Korea Meteorological Administration issued heatwave warnings for the capitals Seoul, Daejeon, Daegu, and Geyonggi-do Province.
And according to its weather forecast, the temperature should rise up to 36 degrees Celsius today in Seoul at its highest. But as you can see right now, it's at 41 degrees Celsius in the middle of a city.
This effect is known as the urban heat island and refers to the area in a city that registers significantly higher temperatures than its surrounding suburb areas due to human activities. The UHI is generally triggered by the concentration of high buildings. In particular, the materials used to build skyscrapers, such as concrete and metal, absorb heat during the day. When the heat is then re-radiated, it can linger in the area for longer periods of time, causing continuous tropical nights throughout the season. With the weather already alarmingly hot this year, taking the necessary precautions to avoid heat-related diseases, such as heat stroke, is of utmost importance.
I can't believe how hot it is right now. I just feel so tired and weary by just stepping out for a couple of hours during the day.
With the weather agency expecting sweltering conditions to continue for the rest of the week, experts are recommending residents, especially the elderly, to stay hydrated and avoid outdoor activities if possible during the day. Lee Unshin, Arirang News.